Guys, I can't even make this up. I'm still in the middle of dealing what I have to deal with. But in the process of doing that, I go to the courthouse, and you guys know Slido Courthouse, you can't have your cell phone. They're very adamant. I had an incident with Marshall, I don't want to get his name wrong. Was it Marshall Schwartz or something? The guy that's always been up there. But he wasn't up there today. But, you know, you leave your cell phone in your car, you go in. Once you go in, on the door, there's the judge's order that you're not allowed to have the phone in the courthouse, which is correct. My issue is, per the First Amendment, you can film the public foyer. And in order to film the public foyer, you would need your cell phone or a camera. So I don't understand how the marshals, they're using the order to kind of push this policy as if it's law. And they're very rude and disrespectful about it. Okay, that's one thing. I get up to the front window and I'm asking the young lady about my situation. I noticed the order on the door. So as I'm asking her about my situation, she says, "You know what, sir? That's been there, but I can actually get you a copy of the order." And I said, "Great, I want a copy of it so I can read it over at home so I can figure out how, is this okay? Is this right?" Because I know how adamant Slidell, the marshals are in that courthouse. They don't want cell phones in there. And I know you guys have probably dealt with it along the lines. The one young lady tells me she can give me a copy. She walks away to go get me the copy. Another young lady walks in. She says, "Can I help you?" I said, "No, ma'am. I'm actually, the other young lady is helping me. But if you could, can I get a copy of the order on that door?" Miss Paula, tells me that no, she can't give me a copy of the order. I said, "Excuse me? Can I get your name?" She's kind of sitting there thinking, wondering, wait, you know, it was a quick dialogue. I don't see why he needs my name. So she gave me her name like it was nothing. And then after the young lady brought me back the order, leverage. You told me I couldn't get something that the other young lady told me I could get and actually went to go get it for me. So you were lying, or you misspoke. You're not representing the city of Slidell. You're not representing me correctly at all. A lot of people aren't representing me correctly at all. They don't know how to be honest, truthful, and stick to their jobs, procedures, and policies. You're supposed to be able to do this. You're not supposed to be able to do that. And yet they still consistently try to give me the bullshit. And I'm not with it. If anybody knows me, you guys know I'm analyzing. I'm hearing you and I'm going, wait, that's not right. And I'm not going to be a pushover. I'm stuck at home, self-quarantining, dealing with jobs and situations and trying to figure out whether this pandemic and what's going on like anybody else. And when you finally come out of the house, you're going to be treated with lies and people feeling like they're allowed to lie, they're empowered to lie to you, when their policy states they're not allowed, that's not the policy. So I'm really calling out Officer Shambrook, I'm calling out Officer Mobley at the jail. She's a lady, glasses, short bob hair, blonde, older lady, Caucasian of course, pretty much stating that you're not allowed to come up to the jail and kind of speak or try to speak to your loved one, anybody in there. They're incarcerated. She also gave me a bond amount, which was incorrect and was less than what the actual bond is, which was very confusing. And that's what I was discussing with the clerk. I said, I was told this over the phone verbatim by an officer. Here's the officer's name. Well, that's not right. So why is the officer giving me a bond amount over the phone if it's not right? What if I went and got that amount out my bank? That exact amount, it wouldn't have been enough. Do you guys understand? So Officer Mobley is definitely getting a complaint. I'll be taking care of that after I weather this situation in this storm, this literal storm outside.